Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla. So I thought today it would be really fun to do a quick tutorial on how to use gouache since I've been practicing with it a ton. As you can see from my previous videos, I've been obsessed with it. So I thought it would be fun to go ahead and do like a quick tutorial on how to use gouache in case any of you are wondering if you should jump into the gouache world. My best advice when it comes to starting with gouache is always start off with something small. So I'm just gonna go on my regular watercolor paper. And I just use watercolor paper for all my gouache drawings. I usually use Strathmore. So here is a Strathmore watercolor paper. So I'm gonna do a quick 4x6 little template. Now when you start off with something small, find something small to actually paint. So nothing too intense or crazy. Like for example, I would go ahead and pick a Disney animal or your favorite animal from your favorite animated movie. I would try to do that first before jumping into a ginormous project. Next thing you want to do is you want to go in and just lightly erase your pencil marks to where only you can see it. And make sure that you have a nice clean plate to put your gouache on, or if it's a paper plate, I have this fun like little Ray Dunn thing. Now when you're making the background, you have to think it is very, you need to go into gouache painting with the same mindset that you have for watercolor. So if you have done watercolor before, then you know exactly what you're going to deal with. So you go in and you make a basic wash like I just did in my little dish. And you see it definitely is thicker, even though it's super watered down, it's thicker than watercolor. So I'm just gonna go in and do a basic all over background with this wash I just created with white and blue. Now that I have a basic wash, I'm gonna try to go ahead and start to add a little bit more around them. So I'm just gonna go and just kind of give more texture and more of a feel. And the thing is, when you are working with gouache, you can add more water to kind of manipulate it and just kind of make it blend a little bit more together. I'm gonna add like a little bit more texture and just to make it look more like a gouache, and that might be adding like a little bit of dry brush technique going on down here. See how I give it, let the paper take over and just drag my brush around. So while I'm waiting for my background to kind of dry, because before I add a little bit more detail to it, I'm gonna go around and start giving the kittens their colors. So I'm gonna start with the front kitten. And I'm gonna do the same process, kind of create a wash for them. And I'm leaving the spaces around where my pencil marks are just a little bit open so I know where to come in detail once I'm done. Just giving them their base colors. as you're probably noticing, you see that I'm starting to add a little bit of shading to kind of mark out where they're gonna go, or I leave a little bit of the pencil marks to show me where I'm gonna go with my colors. But I'm kind of trying to add a little bit of shading in at the beginning. For example, Marie, she might be white, however, it's just easier to give a different kind of shading to her to just add a little bit more depth. So I'm gonna add a little bit of purple to her just to show me where my pencil marks are and where I need to come in and shade after I'm done with all these first base layers. Now I'm going to start going around, jumping around from cat to cat and adding more and more shading, giving it that second layer. Now I'm going to start to go around and add more details and more brush strokes with like a dry brush effect, like you can see right here. Now this is where you think if you need more highlights or more shadows, shading, and you can see this is a perfect opportunity to practice complementary color shading or highlighting, because I used blue on him to shade him instead of a dark black. So I'm going in and I'm just going to add those final details and just give them a little bit more definition. Like I'm just going in with more of a dry brush. Use more of a lighter yellow to kind of line around him And I will start to line them and define them with just a little bit more. But instead of lining them with like a black or a brown, I'm just going to use complementary colors. So I may use like a dark orange or a dark red to line him. This dry brush technique, I go around and I just start to add, instead of a watered down bit of gouache, I'll just add like a little bit of just plain paint and just go around and give it that dry brush look to it. Last thing I like to do is I like to go around with like a solid color and just outline each character just to make them pop a little bit more against the background. Thank you. There we go. There's a quick doodle on how to use gouache. Now, I hope this helps, and I hope you guys give gouache a try. I really, 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 really like it. And I've been, if you follow my Instagram, you see that I've been doing all kinds of gouache paintings. I'm just completely obsessed, and I just love working with it. I hope you guys will give it a try, and I hope you all have a most wonderful day. Bye!